Navi TNC still well underway. It's been a hectic day of Dota 2, Mott. So you're going for the Huskar pick there, but we haven't seen any Huskars yet. It got banned out a bit by LGD versus OG. They enter their third series now versus EG. They are 3-1 coming into this match. Pretty solid showing overall. They looked a little shaky to start the day, but they did manage to close out Alliance 2-0. It was not easy, but they got the job done.
And EG is also 3-1 at this point in time, so this is a very important series for both of these teams. In fact, every series OG has played today is very important. Against Alliance, it looked like there might be a 1-1. LGD, they 1-1, obviously, which is one of the top teams in that group for sure. So EG obviously showing that they are the returning champions. They're coming in, showing that, okay, OG, while you did win the Manila Major as well as the Frankfurt Major, we're here and we're ready to play. They ban out the Fly, Keep of the Light. Darkstar's already banned out for OG. And again, remember that the game they played against Alliance, they had a 17-minute victory with Drow Ranger. And we'll see. Evil Geniuses has first pick. So if they decide to not ban Drow here, we'll see if EG picks it up or if it's going to go to OG. That's the thing. We'll see what they decide to play, either of which I'm not. I think EG might pick it up here, but I'm not sure. We'll see.
By looking revitalized as a squad, as EG will tailor their bans to OG. This leaves the crit Riki in the pool. It leaves Drow Ranger, probably the really big one that comes to mind.
Right.
But Wings have run a ton of. OG has picked up a lot from Wings. What do EG want a first overall pick, though? We've even seen early defensive support openings from teams. EG, a team that, according to PPD, does not run IO.
What's that they do?
Is now running IO. So they first overall pick it. OG, they see that IO and they say, great, we'll take Drow. We'll grab the Batrider for Moon. And their Dire Sight as well. So any kind of a decent start means early objectives and pushing hard into an IO. She's not the best direct deep pusher. She's okay at counter pushing and split pushing, but if you deathfall and the IO's team is far enough behind, she is not going to be a useful hero.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, right now, this was the same first two opening, I think, with OG against Alliance that first game. Lifestealer for Evil Geniuses, though, probably for fear, and we'll see how they decide. I mean, it's a good combination, but with Rage, it's hard because of the tether.
Yeah, you almost certainly are considering the Storm ban at this point. You do have the Drow, so you can possibly crush the lane, but any delivery vehicle, what else comes to mind? Nyx is probably the other big delivery vehicle for Lifestealer. Yeah. Does well against Batrider. Doesn't really need to win its lane too hard. So I'm expecting that to be a consideration as far as bans go for OG. Anything else that jumps out at you?
I'm just thinking of the universe here right now. He, I think, played Bat recently in this tournament. I have, again, EG, we haven't seen much of them because we've been doing the OG games.
Universe has played Bat in one game. He played Nightstalker in another. Nature's Prophet in a third. And, yeah, the two Bat games. So one NP, one Nightstalker, and two Bat, right?
Those are interesting heroes. I mean, you think of universe heroes, you think of Void for sure. Furion sometimes, maybe Bat, but Nightstalker's not a hero you usually see in the offlane. It's a lot of four-position Nightstalkers, and it's a hero you see rarely as well, so we'll see if they decide to go for that offlane. And might be okay, but like you said, Nyx Assassin's probably the one that jumps out to me with the Lifestealer, unless you want to play it in a support role, but they're not the Broodmother, so hope you don't get Brood. And then Huskar is still available, but I'm not sure if either team goes for it in this position.
I think OG would love Huskar right now.
Yeah, I think OG's the more likely team to pick it, and they have first pick coming out of this ban phase.
I'm not really loving an EG Huskar necessarily. They maybe could get away with it.
Good Gust, a well-placed Gust would be nice against the Huskar.
There's still Timbersaw in the pool, who's decent against Huskar. Not in lane so much, but more so like in the mid game. Huskar, Dazzle are both still available.
And they go for Enchantress. So I thought they were going to go for the crit Earth Spirit, but they go for the Enchantress instead, which is definitely an interesting choice for OG.
Likely the Fly hero. I mean, they could run both. They could run Enchantress and Earth Spirit potentially. It's pure damage, so, and it goes obviously good against Rage. Untouchable, not so much, but the impetus is. And it's a hero that can just control the lane. So you can pressure early. It lends some oomph to the push.
More push, yeah, exactly. Especially with Precision Aura. The amount of damage they're going to be pumping out is going to be really nice with the creeps on top of it. So Evil Geniuses kind of have to survive. I wouldn't call it a super early onslaught, but there is a lot of early game here for OG.
They have to find that balance between pressuring the drow in lane and also and being able to threaten for kills and also with the lifestealer, but also still being able to handle the push. Like if you go too all in on the ganking, an OG just five man, you're not gonna be able to take fights. You won't have wave clear. I still think Nyx is a decent compromise. What else is there that goes particularly well with drow? I mean, unless they want to do something really weird with the lifestealer.
I'm just trying to think what they're gonna pick for Sunale as well. That's the biggest thing for me is if they do.
It feels like a storm. It super feels like a Sunale storm.
I'm surprised
right
they
now.
Didn't
they even
ban
get
it
the
out.
CM for the.
I'm surprised
the
OG didn't ban it out.
I'm not sure OG's afraid of storm though.
I guess so.
They have lasso. They have drow sounds, but more importantly, like storm takes a while to come online. They can deathball. I almost feel like EG is trying to convince OG, like it's so obvious that they want Storm, and they really don't want him, and they're going for something else entirely, but
yeah.
Maybe that's overthinking a bit. Who else is good against drow?
Tinker too much in this situation for Evil Geniuses, like to pick a Tinker into this, because I think he might not come online as quickly.
He's not
either.
Really a great lifestealer vehicle, but he is a lot better against the push.
Yeah.
Batrider is pretty good at hunting him. He's so-so, I would say.
Yeah. And I'm kind of curious if they're going to do the Miracle mid drow again. Maybe not in this situation. They ganked him twice with Alliance last time around, and that clearly didn't do anything. I don't know. With 55 seconds left in reserve time, OG are still thinking about what they want to do with the.
There's always the Miracle Invoker. He's fallen out of popularity, but with a drow to help boost him up.
You could do Quaswex with that, so you can have a bit more team fight early on and have more control, and then you could just push with the rest of the heroes as well.
Extremely good at kiting Lifestealer if you don't get burst during rage.
Yeah. They're really thinking about this. So, I mean, they still need the support as well, and it's, like you said, fly playing the Enchantress, although Crit could play it, I'm sure, but I'm trying to figure out if they want to go for something more. Oh, it's an Ogre. That's fine, too. That's actually a great support duo.
It's a high armor, tanky support that is not easy prey for lifestealers.
It just helps out
or any sort of rotation.
It helps at the mid lane, as we've seen it so far do every single time it's been played. Go to mid, throw out an ignite, hit people with your club, go back to whatever you're doing, rotate. If there's no wards, you might be able to get a kill with him. The fire blast, if you can get it up.
And the Bloodlust does give you a bit more scaling heading towards late game.
Yeah, that's true. Bloodlust is so good with drow and enchantress in this game. The amount of impetus you can throw out is just based on your mana pool at that point. And for drow, it's just more attack speed. So it's even better for sieging and taking down towers. Again, move speed as well for Batrider too. Like Ogre's just the Bloodlust has been so good so far. And we've seen it a lot. I think we didn't see it last series, or we saw it in one game last series, but we didn't see it in game number two.
So Sunale heroes, Tinker, Storm, used to play a lot of Lina.
I mean, with what
but
he
that
picks,
doesn't feel like it fits. Invoker, I'm not sure.
He picked like Oracle in LA and a couple of other strange heroes. I don't think he's going to do that,
that
here.
That was a ruse. That was to throw teams off the EG scent heading into TI.
Yeah, I'm sure. That's the only thing we could have thought, like we thought of when it actually happened. Like, what? All right, well, I don't think it'll happen here. In fact, I'm sure it won't happen here.
Let's see Fear pacing behind the squad.
This is where Fear's knowledge is so good here. Like, when he was coaching the team before TI4, like, he was so strong in the draft and helping them coach and figure out picks. Like, that, he's, him and PPD, obviously, Legion very, Commander. Very good. It's another Legion.
OG's turn counter to the Batrider lasso.
Mm-hmm.
That's the main thing.
Duel will take down a couple of these heroes if they get in close, and
it's also a decent hero against push because of the overwhelming odds being good for clearing out waves, but by no means a full solution. I still feel EG are very late on D push heading into this last pick.
Yeah, and the Storm was banned out by OG. I mean, if you get that last pick and you get a last pick Storm for Evil Geniuses, then I mean, they kind of have to ban Storm in that situation. There's no denying it there. So OG, that's their last ban. EG need to take away another core for OG, either a Miracle or a No-Tail hero. And it's the Razor that was very strong for No-Tail in that early game, that first game against LGD, I think it was.
Yeah, so other heroes EG have run, we've talked about Huskar. OG have one more pick though, and it would be a core. 10 seconds remaining. Anything that really shuts down Huskar that's still available. Ursa.
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of weird to pick the Drow. and they're not going to go for it. They go for the Queen of Pain. This is a Na'vi-esque draft, I'm going to say, dating back to like 3 months ago at Dream League. They're running a lot of Dendi Queen of Pain, IO mid for Sunaco, and basically just stomping the mid lane. You get a really fast level 6 on IO, and you use that to snowball elsewhere. So
this is an offline Legion then, I believe?
Certainly looks like a Universe Legion commander right now. Maybe just straight Iron Talon. We'll have to see how much he's in the lane.
But he's played this hero once or twice, but I haven't seen it in a long time. I don't know.
They'd already picked their two supports, and they're like, we need a lasso counter. I mean, the other thing they could have gone for was that Bulba-esque offlane Abaddon, which Secret have been running. But
yeah.
OG, they are going to round it out with the, I won't call it classic partner, but becoming more iconic partner for the Drow, the Dusa.
This is almost the same lineup that won them, and I've said this so much already, 17-minute game against Alliance, and they're clearly trying to do something similar to that in this game with Fly on the Ogre Magi and then crit on the Enchantress. So this is, I guess Evil Geniuses just have to have better lanes than what Alliance had. Like, the laning phase was really good in that game for OG. Even though they lost 4 kills at the beginning of the game, it didn't matter. Miracle died twice, didn't matter. They had a great start for Moon and the Batrider. And so trying to have better lanes here is, I think, the biggest thing for EG against this OG squad.
It's hard to outlane a team with a Drow Enchantress,
right,
though,
that's
right?
The biggest problem, yeah.
Can you really win the lanes? Maybe you can stem the bleeding.
Right.
But barring some amazing IO plays, I'm not sure they can win the lanes. It's going to come down more likely, I think, for EG to good mid-game rotations with the Legion blank, with Queen of Pain getting some runes. But winning the lanes, that will be a tall order.
Yeah, and we'll see if Miracle decides to go mid or if they switch it up and have No-Tail go mid, who's got the Wraith Bandit 2 share tango. So we'll wait and see how the lanes shape up for now. I don't think we'll see that early first split like we saw with Crit running into a Sentry Ward. I do like the supports for OG a lot. This is going to be an interesting game. They already got that one Observer Ward down, though, for EG. I think it might have been placed there.
You're up against Batrider. You're up against Enchantress. Definitely wanting to scout out, just moving through the jungle, whether it's just the Batrider trying to farm, the Enchantress prancing over the ward right now, trying to make a smoke rotation. So pretty good ward placement, I think, overall. And they got it down unchecked. You see EG looking to defend their jungle a bit. Universe starting with the early Mango. Does not rush the Iron Talon, though, so it looks like he will be laning. Maybe he's going to get help from the IO. Queen of Pain is fairly self-sufficient. We get help from the Crystal Maiden, Lifestealer, Fear heading bottom. Can't really do it alone against the Banner Rider, though, for sure. He's going to need some help.
Yeah, and even with help, we saw, well, it's not the same as Terrorblade. They obviously have Rage for the Lifestealer, so he should be much better than what the Terrorblade was in the last game.
He's just going to get kited, though, so they'll have to send someone to help him.
Should be the CM, perhaps?
He started with the stick. Bat's going to get a ton of experience and farm out of this lane if they run it this way, but the trade-off maybe is this dual lane. Azai tethers forward to the ranged creep in the top lane.
Cool little play by the IO.
Makes this ranged creep top move faster, but Fly is there and says, "Thou shall not pass."
And that they're just waiting. He's just waiting for the melee creeps to get
there. I'm pretty sure Fly took a look at some EG replays here. That's not something you see most IO players
do. Wow, they're ranged creeped at first. OG's ranged creeped at first, actually, out of all of the lanes.
This lane's going to push in. And that means they could be fodder for crit on the Enchantress. Potentially sneak his way in. We crit. See all three of our lanes develop.
Yeah, crit has a smoke. They'll move early on in the game for now. Fly, not starting in that mid lane. He's going to go ahead and throw the ignite. He's just helping Miracle out, but I mean, this is going to be interesting, and we'll see how the mid lane does develop. It is that mid Medusa, but with Precision Ore will help out a bit more. Fly will try to find Zai, who's in the tree line, could go to Tether Universe, and
crit looks like he wants to head top and try and find a first blood. With the range creep dying first for the Dire, this lane will push. And they're moving in now. Zai in trouble.
He's got the ignite. Yeah, Zai, he's got the tether movement speed. They need that thunderclap for the movement slow. They're body blocking Universe. Nicely
look at that
done.
Club. With the Alpha Wolf, he's hitting for 80 a pop. Zai has to tether his way home.
That was still some good body blocking from Universe, though. If that wasn't there, Zai's almost certainly dead. And Fly's still trying to get by Universe. Universe is the bodyguard here, and Fly's getting annoyed. Universe is very tanky himself, especially get overcharged with the tether coming through.
Man, Sumail getting super aggressive in the mid lane. He's really doing work on No-Tail here.
Shadow Poison. Bottom lane. They Fairy Fire. Moon looking for PPD. He's in trouble. He's below half HP. Fear getting kited as well, but a couple more right clicks. PPD's got three sticking Apom there. It's going to be another Fairy Fire.
Oh, he's going to get PPD, alive. But who dies first? It is Peter Pan. Damn. Fear also low. Has the stick, has the rage. Could chase this, and with an open wounds ready, can he get in range? It's just terrible, Mott.
Oh man.
Horrible range on that.
A double Fairy Fire. Spaced out perfectly for Moon to get that kill and survive, then kill himself.
Oh, he's gonna deny himself here to the creeps.
Yeah. Ooh.
That... But he got killed by the rage.
Yeah, he's the rage creep killed him.
Oh,
I was gonna say.
Moon, please.
That rage creep has been following him around a lot. Moon did not expect the rage creep to hit him. That's just not great.
But he spent his gold at least, right?
Yeah,
he's
bought
his tranquil.
He bought before he died, but still did not need to give that up. He should have ran more, but I think he was really scared of just getting killed by somebody else, like the Quap rotating in.
A little hand out there from Moon to EG. So overall, Mott, thoughts on the laning stage here? We see the Drow Ranger top free farming, Sumail doing very well in the mid lane, Legion Commander getting decent levels, Fear getting decent levels, but Moon with the first blood. Do you feel like there's a clear advantage for either team?
Right now, it's still pretty even. I mean, yeah, they got that kill for Moon, but obviously giving away the kill, and Fear's still farming well. You have obviously Sumail doing a great job mid laning. He's the Deuce, he's only got 10 CS. Top lane is... it's going way of miracle at this point. I don't think you should be worried right now if you're either team, but EG are having a much better laning phase than what Alliance had, and that's a very good sign for them. And they just really need to get the levels. They get the level 6 on Zai especially, and all of a sudden things get a lot easier. And maybe some new old rotation might do some work as well, but we'll see how things transition is. Fly will rotate back top. You have Crit coming in as well, who's not been super successful. He's only level 1. That's the biggest issue is... Crit's not farming well, because he tried going for the gank, it was unsuccessful, and
he
got no experience.
He has won the top lane as the Drow Ranger, already up to 21 CS, so Miracle having a fantastic time here, and are keeping the IO back a lot. Zai not getting great levels, and not stacking too much. We see a double stack here at the 4-minute mark at the big camp at the top room. Campaign blinking in, Sumail with the aggression on No-Tail once again. He just keeps on committing on this. No-Tail does have the stick charges, though, so Sumail will have to back up, bottle up, almost dying to the right click there.
That would have been real bad. And he gets a double Null-Tail. It looks like he's going to
be... And they're moving in. Rotation from Moon. He wants to punish, but
TP's
Sumail
already there.
Going to be healthy. Zai did get the bottle back for him, so full charges now for Sumail. So he gets 6 bottle charges back to full HP. It seems like EG really want this Queen of Pain to snowball.
And Sumail with that double null tally, it's going to be tankier now. Universe is alone at this point. Press the attack, will heal him back up, but he's under the tower. They'd have to die for this. And Crit is smoked up, ready to go, looking for a potential pickoff right now. He has to wrap around maybe, but by the time he does that, the smoke of deceit might be already done. So he's going to have to stay. And he actually just wastes the smoke. He says, I can't do anything with this. The tower has the creep wave right now. It's pushed up too far. He is walking up, but Universe is going to be, I think, fine with Zaya now here.
I like this move by PPD as he moved into the enemy jungle in the meanwhile. And oh, they are going to go there, though. Universe top lane, working on the Legion Commander. Quick purge for the extra move speed to get out.
Could press the attack.
Yeah.
It's too fast with the tether as well.
But yeah, PPD, he I believe smoked into the enemy jungle or just walked in.
He had an invis rune, I think.
Oh yeah, the invis rune. Okay, he drops the ward. He also steals one of the big creeps, so gets vision on the potential movements. Crit moving forward slows down the Batrider jungle farm a bit, assuming at some point Moon will go back to that. Tries to delay that timing as No-Tail gets harassed mid. PPD creeping in, gets another ward down.
Sumail's starting to really take advantage of the CS over No-Tail right now. With 17 only for the Medusa, you have
the lock forward. Here we go.
Sonic Wave not there with the mana. He has it now. He's going to use it, and that's the kill. I don't even know if he needed it with 3 heroes there. Sumail was getting a bit low in terms of HP and mana. They're going to come in, though, with Crit and Moon, but they have no way of chasing this down with the tether move speed again going for EG's way. It's just too much, and that's a great kill.
He turned on the mana shield quite late there. I think after he'd taken like 400, 500 damage already. Probably dies anyway, but it makes it a bit easier.
So Sumail's winning mid, but top lane is going the way of Miracle Drow. And then, of course, Moon is having a pretty great time. Most CS in the game currently. He's 3rd in net worth, and 1st is going to be Sumail, and that's the good thing going the way of EG. But OG might start pushing pretty soon with the... They had more experience on the Enchantress, I'd say they could push earlier, but they can go pretty soon, I think, if they want to.
EG closing in on the duel, just one more creep for Universe, he'll have it. The Queen of Pain ult on cooldown. That's going to be their big follow-up damage. And Duel is a lot like Chronosphere in that you want to have damage to dump into it to quickly find kills. Buff doesn't have her ult. I feel EG are very lacking in it, so they may have to wait until that's available to make their next move.
I'm wondering when Sumail's going to make a rotation. He's just going to sit mid for a while.
He's got to wait for the Quaffle.
That and probably a good rune, I think. And if they want to go and push, they can, but probably have to react to OG's pushes and what they decide to do. A lot of good vision from EG. They have one ward here in the mid lane, another one in the jungle, like you talked about. Moon getting caught, Openwood's bottom lane.
Has the lasso, not there. Though.
Yeah, I think that's what Fear was afraid of with the lasso and the TP coming in as well from the Ogre. And it was a little too far behind. PPD wasn't quite underneath the tower when they were going on that, so they have to back away. Won't be successful in finding that kill on the Batrider. Going for the Bracer, still can go for the drum, especially with the Windlace up as well. He's going to have it soon.
This is probably the best we've seen a team do against a Drow Ranger draft in the landing stage in a while, and doing it without getting a huge kill advantage. Like in the, what was it, the Alliance game, we saw 4 kills to nothing and a first blood and no kills given up, and they were still barely leading.
This is an interesting infest bomb. This is going to be really...
Nobody expects the IO no boots infest bomb, I'll tell you that right now.
Tethered to universe, it goes to the creep instead. That's fine.
I guess with Tether, you have some mobility, you know, this is cute.
If OG decided to go there and turn that around, they could easily have just infested out. They see that there is going to be fear there, and Crit and everyone else are going to back away, and it's actually going to be EG putting pressure, I think, at this tower first and foremost, but down bottom is where they're going to look for the trade. They've rotated Miracle down here after top lane. This tower is actually pretty low. It's below half HP. This bottom tier one tower for EG is going to fall, and it's going to be a trade. Whip will go out for OG in the top lane, and yep, it's going to be a trade. And they might even get mid as well, if they're not careful.
Yeah. Oh geez, they've got the better tower damage for sure. EG still working on this one. Bottom lane though, Universe moving in, he gets the dual Miracle. He gets denied though, Fly.
Wow.
What a play by the Ogre.
Shadow Strike actually coming in to help.
Still gets the dual damage though, even though it was a deny. So Universe now. Rule number one complete for a secondary kill, but Fly. Oh, we'll go down there. Still Moon on the chase. He lassos up Sumail, but it's instantly perched off Moon. On the chase, the flame break, he turns back for Universe, deciding Sumail will have a blink in time. I won't be able to get this kill, but now the IO arrives and Moon's forced to TP out. Can they nuke him down? They're gonna have not enough depth.
Make it out. They actually had Crit and No-Tail rotating in. I don't know. They're so fast when IO's there with press the attack as well. It's just so tough. Moon, he did everything he could. He had so many stacks of sticking Napalm, and he's just not able to get either of those kills with the press the attack, obviously taking the lasso off. And that's so frustrating for him because that's at least one kill that he should have gotten that gets away because of move speed like that. And he would have, like, that's an instance in the Alliance game where he would have gotten the kills. They didn't have anything to buff up the move speed to deal with the Batrider. And I think he just got the drum, so that might help him a little bit to find those solo kills if he can get it. But there's the Infest inside Sumail. This is the vehicle we've been looking for. They have good vision in the jungle. They can start with a rotation up to that area if they want to go for a kill.
And now the Quap ult is cooled down, so expect this from EG. Every time the Queen of Pain ult is ready, they will be looking for a move, but there's Dire Vision scouting this Queen of Pain. Yeah. Sumail has been seen, but without a blink on Batrider. The lockdown's not reliable. Crit gets caught out here and completely stomped out by Fear and Sumail. Another nice pick. It was scouted. I guess OG not realizing there was a lifestealer inside, but you see that Queen of Pain marching around on your side of the river. You've got to expect this big gank.
First duel maybe coming in, press the attack first. They have the spirits, and there it is. Can they get the kill? They're going to jump into Sonic Wave. Hits on it too nicely. Not dead yet. No duel victory, but they've got one kill, and they're about to get two, but the last one comes out. No tail does end up going down, but it's Moon alone right now. Crit is back up and alive, ready to go. And Miracle's top pushing that tower. It's 3 dead for OG. Sumail looking for more. Jump in Crit. Shadow Strike.
Get
here, I think.
Crit is just so underleveled at this point, and he doesn't even have a single point in Untouchable, so Sumail can just easily right-click him down, finds another kill. That fight, there was 3 seconds to go on the Medusa ult, and she had some mana shield on. So during the duel, she lost so much mana that she couldn't actually cast the ultimate, the Stone Gaze, after the duel. And without the Stone Gaze, there's just no way to take a team fight if you're OG, so pretty crucial. Mark of misfortune, I guess you would say, it is the really unfortunate situation, but EG now punishing OG, and after that latest punish, they have finally gotten a gold lead here. About 1,500, maybe 2,000 or so.
Is this a good enough start for EG for them to, I think, be in a good position against the Drow later on down the road?
Drow lineups will eventually come online. It's just a question of, do you have enough to deal with it? We'll see as Boone moves in, find TPD.
He's going to get caught.
No Queen of Pain ult. And
if, like, that's all they voodoo's in the tower. I don't know if it's that bad.
That's my one concern. Io and Crystal Maiden are so freaking squishy. He's in deep.
Base armor, and here comes the duel, but they have that stone gaze, and Universe gets caught with it. The right push coming through. Universe about to fall. Overwhelming odds might be able to get him out alive. The high ground uphill miss will not be there. Sumail blinks away. They've taken down three. Jeez. Back and forth. And yeah, I was just asking, I guess the Drow lineup is starting to come online now. They just added a five-man and start pushing up, and they get three kills with it, too.
Remember, they don't have Impetus yet. They haven't taken Roshan yet. No Tail has yet to really build a big item. He's going to get his drums momentarily. Batrider Blink is not online. We haven't seen a fight with Stone Gaze until that one, so a lot of things we haven't seen. Sumail bottom lane is going to get silenced and lasso. They stacked him a bit, but a Centaur stomp, if needed, would secure the kill. It's not needed. Great pick by OG.
So huge.
And that lead that EG worked all game, just scrappily trying to accrue. 8-1 was the score, Mott. They're trailing already as far as gold goes, and experience might be next.
Yeah, Fear and Zive looking to contest this Roshan. No bot for 15 seconds. OG will back out, no lasso. Missing out on some mana here. Miracle looking for a target. There's going to be at least a Mystic Snake, but Zai has the infused raindrops. Overwhelming odds coming out. Firefly, Moon. They get frostbitten.
They really need the blink. Kill. Their catch is not very good right now.
He's supposed to. Once they get Roche, it'll have it, but
I think. Oh, Courier. It's pretty far.
Wait, Gus comes down. He doesn't get the rage off in time. I don't know if they can bring him down. They have lasso, but they slowed up. Overwhelming odds onto pretty much everyone. Fear.
That did some overwhelming damage right there.
Nuts.
That must have been like a 600 damage nuke or something.
They had Sonic Wave on top of that. That would have been dangerous. And they actually push him out of the Roche pit. And so EG, they contested successfully. They don't let him get it. If they had gotten that Roshan, then OG have the Aegis. They have the Blink Dagger like you talked about for the Batrider, which is what they really need. So he's going to spend some time in the jungle, use his Firefly up, and EG will do the same and try to find some ult of their own.
Well, the game slows down now. EG, you have relocate available for Zai for the next fight. Should come back relatively soon. Blink Dagger about to be picked up by Universe. He's won one duel. Sumail has gone for a Veil, which I'm not sure how I feel about it this game. It's not the best late game item for Queen of Pain. Her ultimate is pure damage, so it's not going to be buffed by the Veil. Really, they have, like, I'd say okay nuke damage. It's not amazing by any means.
If you get that Veil with the overwhelming odds like you got before and a Quap Scream or Sonic Wave, you're getting two kills at least.
The issue, though, is you can't count on like a 5-0 overwhelming odds by any means.
No, but he's hit so many of them, or at least a couple of them this game, that I think that the Veil is a pretty good pickup so far. They got a couple of blinks as well. Universe has picked his up. I think they got the Batrider blink just now coming on for OG. And Roche is still that point of contention. Good lane ward coming out for EG. Close to that tier 1 tower down bottom so they can see TP's in. And if someone wraps around into the river. And everyone's around Roche again, so.
What else do you have? You have the Infest damage. Infest is actually quite decent when you get the level, what is it, like, could be like 400 damage with the double Infest if you get it off the level 3, I think. It scales pretty well, but you're not going to have the leveled up Infest for a while. So, anyway, OG, flanking around.
Wrap around.
Looking from behind. You're addicted to the old complexity, but here comes the lasso. Oh, or not!
Lane break. Jump in. There's the duel. Stonegate in front of Universe to make sure he doesn't have that right, because he just stands at his tracks. It's still Zai going down first, and next it's going to be the Legion.
They haven't even used lasso yet, Mod. This is number three, unless Sumail can blink. He whips the ultimate, and then Zai's insult to injury, as OG will now march towards the Lifestealer and potentially towards the Roche pit.
It's another three heroes. They lose the Enchantress. Crit doesn't really give a damn at this point. They just want to get these kills, and then because of that, they secure Roche. Again, the damage is so strong. Bloodlust, you have the Drow Ranger Precision Aura. crit throwing at Adeptus, and I love that the No-Tail just walks in front of the duel, stone gaze them, makes it so they don't get any duel damage or like he can't click during the duel because of that stone gaze, and there's nothing he can do against that. It pierces spell immunity, so even with a BKB, you're still not going to be able to get that duel victory off.
Yeah, we didn't see the Queen of Painel until very late in that fight. I guess Sumail got silenced by something.
He must have been gusted, or...
I think he must have been gusted, because it wasn't used on him later on in the fight either, so... In any case, does come back to really hurt them, but... We saw that the Veil overwhelming odds, like, it did decent damage, but it wasn't enough for a killing blow, and... This build, I guess you're gonna... maybe skip the Orc, you go straight into a BKB, but when there's a... Drow Silence, you pretty much have to get a BKB or you're just going to be shut down in team play.
He picked up a Ring of Health. It's interesting. Leads me to believe he's going Linked Spear against the Lasso and against Ogre Magi and his Fire Blast.
Probably the most likely pickup.
They're going for Roche. It's
Aether Lens.
Oh, it could be that, but
that feels very all in on this stage of the game.
If you really want an Aether Lens, that's kind of. You can get that whenever.
Well, OG say we'll take this whenever. Roshan is theirs, and I'm bringing No-Tail top. Remember, Medusa hasn't really gotten items yet. Has picked up the drums, 1800 gold banked for No-Tail.
Is Drum Yasha the build most people go for, and unless you're Mushi, relocate bottom. They're gonna find Moon this time around, and he should be dead here.
Link forward to Sumail, so let's isolate him, but the lasso comes through, and the lasso goes out. The lasso will roughly cool down like shortly after he respawns. It'll be like 30 seconds where he doesn't have it, so not a big deal. But on the back of that EG, they might take this tier 1 bottom.
They needed something like that. They'll be able to get a tier 1 tower here unless OG rotated a couple of people top. They will TP out Miracle down towards bottom lane, but by the time they get there, the glyph is going to be gone. So it's going to be a pretty low tower. Walking up Miracle, and bring down an Observer Ward, and now you back away if you're EG, and that's exactly what they're going to do. Not able to get that tier 1, but they don't put it in deny range, which is nice.
So how urgently do OG feel they need to push here? They've picked up the Dragon Lance, they have a level 2 Bloodlust, crit has Impetus.
I don't think they're that concerned with how late this game
goes.
Oh,
you see a Veil Queen of Pain, I don't think you're too worried about your late game.
I mean, Fear is getting okay farm, but the Universe duel has been a big problem. Like, he can't do enough damage because Stone Gaze is always used promptly by No-Tail in the perfect scenario, usually. Stops him from doing any damage during the duel. So they're not really concerned, I don't think, about how this late game is gonna shape up.
The other thing that worries me for EG is they don't have great tools to deal with Medusa. They don't have Mana Burn. They don't really have a reliable way to stop Stone Gaze from coming off as Sai will get lassoed, caught out, dragged back. Has a lot of damage to deal with and will end up getting fire blasted down. Well, meanwhile, OG pushing in bottom lane, going for the Sansa PPD, doesn't connect on Universe, who is going for the jump.
But the Stone Gaze comes out. He needs to be in front of Universe, and now he is, and still brings him down. Fear in trouble with Rage up, infests out.
Oh, that's what Drow needs. More damage, Fear. He can't take it. They're skating forward. Big Daddy going to work, and Fear is going back to the well while Miracle continues the siege. From the side, Sumail will come. He's looking for the cleanup. Can the young gun get it done? He gets the kill, but he gets flame break backwards. They're going to continue pursuit. A fly stun, a Miracle silence, and Sumail trying to do too much for the team will die.
Probably not worth it.
It just did have a couple of minutes left, but giving up another kill on a core
might have to buy back now to defend this tier 3 tower. We'll see though. They have both the No-Tail Dusa and Miracle here, and they have the Dragon Lance Miracle. They could safely siege this tower for a fair bit of time. This is going to be tough. We'll see if they can get a little bit of chip damage, and it looks like that's it. They won't stay around too long. Even though they have, of course, killed that Quap, they're going to just head back home. Universe, duel, it's available. No-Tail. They might actually find a duel victory here, and it looks like they will. Universe will get it done.
Still only the level 1 ult, but he will take that kill. Desperately need a dual win for EG. About a 2,500 gold lead or so for OG, it looks like. 1,000 experience advantage, it's not really a big lead by any means, but still, just look at the way EG have itemized. We're seeing a Legion Commander who goes Blink first. He's expecting a lot of dual kills. Sumail going for the early Veil has some synergy with their team, but it's not a huge Magic Burst lineup. This is a draft that was expecting to get a little more done. So I think OG are slightly happier. And again, it's a really good Dusa game overall. But with that said, still anybody's game. Map control is relatively even, some good deep wards for both teams, and EG, Mott, they're on the smoke.
OG are back behind their tier 3 tower, underneath their tier 3 tower, ready to, I think, maybe smoke themselves. They have one on fly, waiting for the respawn from No-Tail. EG, did they put any wards down when they invaded the jungle? It looks like no. PPD doesn't have any. He did put one to the entry to the jungle, but that's it.
Are you in communication with Peter?
No, I am not.
Okay. Are you sure?
I do not have any communication devices.
I question your allegiances, Mott.
OG are crushing it, though, I have to say. I mean, this is similar to the draft strat they ran. They're doing a pretty good job with it. They have the late game with Adusa. PPD almost dies. He narrowly avoids a gank. He's pretty slow, but...
Season Ogre almost dies. That's the Crystal Maiden life.
Yeah, I mean, like, he gets stunned there. He's just dead. To probably Crit coming in with the Impetus. And Crit's actually done very well. But the bottom lane, there's going to be a last one to Universe. And he died very quickly. That double damage rune coming out.
Drow Ranger is hitting for almost 500 damage per auto attack.
Yeah, the Alpha Wolf's also.
Miracle has a Divine Rapier, guys. Where did this come from, EG say? It's No-Tail up in front. And Miracle looking to end this game very quickly. He will 3 or 4 shot PPD, focusing on the Rangerex, going for the easier kill. But 2 mail just looked to blow him up. Kaboom!
Wow.
Blink and you'll miss it.
That's what he wants to do with the Veil. He's best out, No-Tail in trouble. He doesn't have much mana left. We'll try to TP away. And he gets frostbitten at the last second. PPD coming in. Looking for the relocate up front, but everyone else has TP'd away. Zai was looking for more, but that was a very fast Veil into Scream Sonic Wave combo that it finishes up his Lincoln Sphere because he kills the topmost net worth. Sumail keeps this game in hand for EG for the time being.
Yeah, OG were not expecting that damage up. Holy crap. They just exploded.
That's why he got Veil. That's what he wanted to do in the first place.
Yeah, if you get an item like that, you have to make those plays. If you're not finding those big double, triple kills and convincingly winning team fights, then you'd be better off with an Orchid or something that scales better in the late game. But that was the first time where it really showed its potential. It was a big time to have it. And after that, Miracle says, I need a little more HP. Buys the Staunch.
Yeah, I think BKB might not be a bad idea later on down the road for Miracle if that continues to happen. It might just be a positioning thing that he needs to rectify. He's up front, no Aegis, being very aggressive. He's like, well, I have a double damage rune, but he didn't expect to get blown up that quickly.
Very even game, Mott. Has never been more than a 2,500 gold lead.
I mean, again, it's going to come down to... Can this Medusa get enough farm? And No-Tail is doing very well. He's going to get the Lincoln Sphere coming out pretty soon. I think he has the Void. No, the Perseverance is flying out to him right now, and so he just needs that Ultimate Orb and the recipe as well. And then he'll have some good regen, some good damage from the Phase Drum Yasha. In that late game, Medusa is very strong.
Salt Caress. Nearly done here for the old man. Needs the Hyper... sorry, not the Hyperstone, the Plate Mail. About 700 gold to go, so... Pretty big item versus Drow. There is still the Impetus pure damage to worry about, but Brawl could be a very important difference maker. We head towards the later stages of the mid game now, 25 minutes in. PPD, he's become public enemy number one in the eyes of OG. They are rushing towards this Crystal Maiden, and
you are dead, Peter. I am sorry to tell you, Flame Break, Firefly damage, and a couple of right clicks, and that's more than enough to kill him. It's a good effort.
And she did burn up indeed. How appropriate.
Poor CM. How many times has he died this game? Not many. 4 times. That's not bad for a CM, I think. Given who they're playing against, the heroes they have to deal with. And EG, that actually gives them good base. So space created top lane for Sumail to get this 2-2 tower. Glyph will go. They're not in really any good position to defend it. They will have No-Tail come up, but there's a couple other heroes for EG. Press the attack, but actually I think Universe got hit by the Mystic Snake, so he was actually just getting out of there.
And forced to run away as OG picked up a gem for Moon. This is probably the item that they'll rely on to turn this game, keeping the map control advantage. They have the Batrider, the superior vision hero. EG don't have anything like it, no Nightstalker, no Beastmaster. They have mobile heroes, but they are not going to win a battle of warding unless they're getting kills. So, barring that, OG will gain map control.
That
may give them the edge heading towards the next Roshan. Now only about 45 seconds off. A very timely respawn for OG.
That AC is very important. Sure, there's a lot of magic damage from OG, but there's also a lot of right-click damage from Miracle as well as No-Tail and Crit, but that's pure. So, EG will be able to with the Assault Cross coming out, it's going to help them a lot and give them some right click of their own with Sumail as well. They have the Infest Bomb. They're looking to contest. Roche is respawning pretty soon, I would imagine. In fact, it's about to respawn right now in 10 seconds. And Moon of the high ground, he's got the Firefly.
The Miracle's the flanking Drow with a Blink Dagger, counting on those quick reactions to make it out of here. Often you see a Drow this confident.
Yeah, that ball's
now scouting with the Satyr Banisher, so good use of the Helm of the Dominator just to make sure that if he's going to get jumped, he'll have a split second extra to react. Now OG starts to wrap around onto the pit.
It could take this very fast, but I don't think it's fast enough given EG's positioning.
Sumail, the Purge Creep's going to get to work. Miracle blinks in, going for the Gust, but Sumail just able to get out in time.
Now OG are on the back, but they're running away. They kill the Satyr Banisher, which was giving vision for OG. OG kind of setting up a trap here towards that Roche pit, towards that river area. They drop a ward down. They're sitting in the trees with no tail. They really want to be able to take this Roche. This is dangerous.
Moon's looking for the leap, Mott.
Let's get the Firefly.
Who's he going to find? Radiant Vision, not the best here. The Batrider sees all. But nobody wants to go.
Somehow Sumail is always a little too far out of Moon's range to be able to grab him. And they flick it and gust him. But Spear jumps right out. Miracle might be trouble. There's going to be the lasso. Stone Gate comes out as well. Universe is going to get caught by it. And it looks like he will be brought down first.
Do go for the relocate save. Unfortunately, that means Queen of Pain not in the fight initially as Miracle barely survives. 30 HP. Kill this man, EG. They just can't do it. He flicks to the north. Can they clean up with the Drow on the run? They bring down the Enchantress. Surviving, turning back for the Deuce of Fear is very strong at this point, but his rage ends. He needs to back away.
Hotel is doing some work, but it's not nearly enough.
Miracle's still alive!
Oh my God, he killed everybody!
Almost gets the Crystal Maiden as well. Mamma mia!
Io doesn't have relocate. He's just gonna buy back a TP in and try to get to the tether in time. Fear will get there. Tether with his eye, but that's it. I mean, that Miracle somehow lives with like 10 HP. He shoots everyone from the high ground to the low ground, and they finally kill him with PPD getting a CM. I guess it was the Crystal Nova that did
yes.
the work there.
If she didn't have another nuke ready, she was going to lose that battle because he would have outlifestealed her right click damage, even with 30 HP.
These fights are nuts. They're just fighting all over the place. I mean, the Blink Dagger. Miracle engagement, he gusts out Universe, and Fest comes out, he somehow gets away after all of that damage coming from Sumail.
The thing that's really cool about that play is when you Blink Gust to start the fight, it means Sumail won't be able to instantly burst the Drow. Then you start the Stone Gaze, and by the time the Drow is not silenced, the Stone Gaze is kicked in. So either she's also stunned, or she's turned and run away, in which case the Drow Ranger actually gets to continue fighting. So, I love the way that Miracle played this, and I think had he not been the one to initiate, like if you're just going with Lasso, it just gets perched off and you don't get anything done in the fight. It's very unconventional, but I think it was a lot more effective than the traditional route as far as initiation goes.
They have Sonic Wave back up. No, 30 seconds. EG still are going to try to contest this. How fast is this Roche dying? Not fast enough. They should have Stone Gaze back up, but they do.
They see Moon, I think, with these spirits. No, it didn't actually hit him.
Blinks away in time. Not to mention he's a 4-staff. Doesn't really want to lose that gem, but Firefly now going to be down pretty soon. Overwhelming odds from Universe.
Who's going to make that first move? Sumail is the man.
He misses. He whiffs. Now they can get out. The Stone Gaze comes in. It's Sumail. They have the relocate save there. In time, the last one comes down. They get the gust off as well. And that means Sumail and Dai will both go down. Universe getting low and slowed down by Miracle, who just right clicks him to death. And this time, it's 3-0 for OG. And they, I think, can finally take Roche after maybe 5 minutes of footsie.
Well, the game of footsie ended in OG braiding out a giant boot and just stomping on EG's uncovered foot. That is not how EG thought the game was supposed to be played. Now this leads to an Aegis. They will also hold the mid lane here, forced to back away. OG in command of this game.
There. I don't think, yeah, EG didn't have any vision over towards the Roche pit, so when he blinks
This is where Quap really struggles not having to BKB.
Yeah.
You could still get lassoed, but you are just going to get destroyed if there's any sort of stun and... Of course, they have the Ogre to start it off, so they can stun with the Ogre first, then they can Gust, and they can like drop the Lasso in even later in the fight. So you can't remove the Drow Silence, you have no way to do it with the Ogre stun. That's just way too much lockdown for Quap to be going in first, unless she instantly kills someone, which has not happened since that one fortuitous fight in the bottom lane.
Universe did silence immediately after popping the blade mail. Frostbite and a no-tail, but he's very tanky. Sumail blinks out, they really want this Rax, they get the melee range. gonna be low for the remaining majority of this engagement. They'll back away for now, and no kills happening.
EG, now down one Rax. It's only one, but unfortunately for them, it's a melee, and then the range, then the falling to the creep. So a full lane caved in. Other two lanes still have tier 2s, but you have to imagine OG with a fresh Aegis just going to be marching from lane to lane and looking for at least one more Rax during this Aegis.
They have the Lincoln Sphere now for the Deusa, so...
Speaking of wraparounds, Mott, here we go.
This is really important for EG. They need to get that kill, that immediate kill that you talked about before with Sumail on the Veil. But
they're expecting OG to make this exact move!
The Gust again, and Sumail is in so much trouble. Good duel on the Miracle, but and the Relocate save. Still, though, that's Universe dying instantly, and PPD is next.
Bob comes back, but OG just looking too tanky. Miracle will drop, but he's got a second life. Can they get the job done? Nota running out of mana, but he's going to Manta and continue to duke it out. Fear as the rage ends. The pain begins. Silence, clubbed, and dead. Four have fallen. Frantic buyback from the Legion Commander. This game has gone off a cliff for EG. Just look at the gold breath. All red dots peppering it. As that one was a 4,400 gold swing, it looks like.
I mean, there's a reason why Wings love this Drow Ranger so much and why OG picked it a couple of times and they've started picking it more. It's just so strong alongside everything else they have. The Bloodlust combos up perfectly. Just no way to deal with it. Universe on this Legion's having a really rough game. Even gets Custed at the tail end trying to run and look for maybe a blink and a duel, but OG are able to back away. They don't get any buildings there other than the tier 2 in that top lane, but successful in taking out a lot of these buybacks from EG.
So we're going to see this fight again. Sumail, again, forced to start the fights. They get the relocate save, which didn't happen last fight, so I never even used it. But when he gets relocate saved out, that means that you're just going to lose a hero who's being focused by five. So they go back in. They manage to kill the Drow once, but you have to kill her twice. And that's just not something they can do. They only have one Quaffle. Even Burst here single time is very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Fear is just food whenever Rage is down, and it's a lifesteal. You can only really focus one hero at a time in these fights. So I look at the way OG have itemized. They build a Hurricane Pike on crit. Drow already has a Blink Dagger and Gust to work with. Everyone has mobility. Bloodlust in the form of the Ogre. Force Staff on him for additional mobility as well. And Force Staff on the Bat. All of these heroes are really good at kiting and really good at repositioning in some form or fashion. That makes it a very difficult game for Lifestealer, even with Io support. And Io's not really supporting him. Fear is pretty much on his own. It's always Sumail who's being tethered and protected.
Yeah, and when they're going for these engagements, a lot of the time they don't have vision when Sumail is jumping in. They didn't have vision at the Roche fight. They didn't have vision when they were going in at that fight towards the secret shop that was just happening. So a lot of these engagements, Sumail's blinking in mostly blind with maybe vision of one or two heroes. And that's it. And so he has to get relocated safe half the time because he's just in maybe a too bad of a position. He doesn't have a blink head or blink in and blink out with like his own W like you'd see with like a Murano leap or something. But
yeah,
that's the difference maker.
Thing that I think looking at more of these Drow games that really separates the, you know, the decent Drow players from the top tier ones is more than anything is A, positioning, but B, using the Gust effectively.
Yeah.
Like, that has been so big for OG this game. It's something we've also seen a lot. I believe it's Shadow from Wings who plays it, where a well-placed, a well-timed Gust can just win you a team fight. It doesn't seem like that important of an ability. Like, most people think of Drow, oh, she's a pushing hero, precision aura, she does a lot of damage, but that silence can be devastating, especially in cases like this where key heroes do not have it, but top lane, there's the duel.
Universe again gets a full one off. This time the Sonic Wave, no Tails, mana is gone. They'll bring him down. Moon in trouble, already used the lasso and fear. Finally starting to go to work, but again, the damage. Miracle has a DD and is going to work. Since the lifesteal is pretty good. They get the press of the attack, it's not enough. Two for two exchange. They might get Universe. He blinks out and dodges the last raw auto attack from Miracle.
Hey, buddy.
They'll find him, though. That's just awkward. Still, Miracle gets the
kill. That was a fight where they instantly killed the Medusa, and Drow was getting focused by a lifestealer during Rage. If he didn't have a DD rune, I think OG get crushed there, but he did.
Bloodlust.
All the little things not going EG's way. Sumail jumping back in. Can he focus Miracle down? It seems like he will be able to, but they knocked another tower. Their tier 4s are getting hit. They need more kills. They're going to relocate forward, look for Fly. Can they kill him either? TP out. He's going to make it too. They get the cores mod, but they lose another tower. The tier 4s taking chip damage. And EG not taking objectives of their own during this time.
Yeah, it's just little by little, they're kind of dwindling down. Fear going down yet again, or, well, first time in a while, actually. He's only got two deaths. I shouldn't say yet again. He's had a great game, but That's still a big death, though. I mean, every time he dies...
And he had... Well, he's only died twice, but he had to buy back as
right,
well.
That's
so
the thing.
It has been a big drop-off in terms of net worth, where he was once... He was even with the Dusa for a large part of this game. Now he's 5k gold down on her and, you know, not even able to scratch the surface of what Miracle's been able to farm.
So Notel, Manta, you've got your Lincoln Sphere now, which, of course, you really need that Lincoln Sphere before you get the Manta style. You need some of those stats first before you use the Manta. But now that he has it, he has plenty of damage with the Precision Aura on top. And 3.2 probably goes for Butterfly next, although Scotty's pretty good as well. I don't know. What do you think for Notel next on his itemization?
Yeah, both of those are quite good. I don't really think there's anything else you need to go for. Like, you could get something a little bit unconventional, like a Hex, but I would say almost certainly Butterfly or Scotty is the grab. Is
really out of bounds. That is a great location for him to be. They need time. They need to relocate out, but he is not there in time, and he just gets chopped down by crit, the Hurricane Pike, and the Impetus damage.
Map control. That is the name of the game for OG right now. Only two wards on the enemy side, but they are two of the best wards in the game. These can pin your opponent completely back in the base, free up Roshan control, prevent them from farming. What do you do if you're EG? You're running an IO, so you'd think maybe they can split push, but push that well, Mott. Quap is not a great building sieger. There's no like low-hanging fruit towers to grab at this point. Lifestealer can siege, but if you commit to towers like that, Batrider will punish you. It's a BOT bat with Blink Force. They're going to try for a relocate, just a solo move by Zyda to shove this top lane out, but that shows you the Dire Straits EG are now
in. Right. I mean, they didn't bring anybody up there because I think they might be scared to do so. They're like, okay, Zai is expendable. He goes down. At least he pushes in the lane a little bit. And he did a pretty good job there, even with a relocate now and cooldown for 54 seconds. They at least shove the top lane and get some more time for EG to regroup. The biggest thing for EG has been this Gem of True Sight for OG. Like, they've taken away all of that map control. And there's EG won that last fight, or made it even, I guess, with Universe by moment of surprise, jumping in, getting off the duel, getting the kill. That was the important part. They don't have that vision. They never really do have that vision in this game because of the Gem of True Sight that was picked up pretty early for Moon.
Yeah, generally with IO, you'll see a good hero to start the fights. Nightstalker, especially for the early game, Batrider comes to mind.
Beastmaster as well.
Yeah, or Beastmaster is probably the best example. EG, Legion gives you the initiation, but he doesn't give you the vision, as you point out. And I think that is a gap in the EG draft, but bigger issue is just that they've lost all their outer towers in lane of Brax. So even if they can push that bottom lane out, very hard to get out in the jungle and deward.
So despite Crit having maybe a rough early game, he has a Moon Shard now along with this Hurricane Puck. No Aghanim Scepter, but plenty of range.
And it's not like you can be focusing Enchantress, right? You have to kill the Drow or the Medusa to start the fight. Speaking of which,
they're going to go for a duel, and Miracle might actually be in trouble, but Universe taking a lot of damage as well. Sonic Wave finishes it off and gets on Fly as well. From the backside, Crit coming in, and No-Tail as well. Can they get anybody down? PBD, Freezing Field won't do enough die now. Last it up, can't get that relocate out. In fact, he's already used Universe. He's able to get back home. Shumel going to work. Crit about to go down. Looks like the last right click will get the job done, and Notel might be next.
That's three down, looking for Notel as well. They even bought back up PPD for this. They're gonna kill Big Daddy too. Four down, can they make it five? Moon, four step, TP. He saves the gem. Still a very good fight. EG showing a pulse here. Despite being down a full lane of Brax, we'll see this one again. Perfect initiation by Universe, gets off the Blink duel, is getting the bonus attack speed from the tether and the overcharge. Sumail finishes the kill. He also clipped, I believe it was the Ogre with the Queen of Pain ult, so that was basically a free second kill.
Yep.
Crit, if it's a slightly more even fight, I think does more damage here, but he gets kind of isolated by Sumail and Fear, and he's just too squishy, brought down very early.
And I think, again, part of the reason they went for that fight is this Observer Ward placed over towards the river, which is kind of where I think they had vision in the first place, and they went for that duel. Otherwise, I don't know if they go for that fight without that vision, or if they do, it's going to be Sumail again jumping in first and looking for a Blink Scream and blowing some heroes up. But that's a huge fight. I mean, that's a Medusa dead for 23 seconds. They get a lot of gold off of that. There's still a long way to go for EG, but something to help them out is going to be taking Roshan. It is up and available right now. And if OG want to contest, they have to push the waves out first. Let's see if they do that.
It's going to take that level of execution for EG to take this. But OG.
Smoke is coming.
Do have a Batrider. And they are moving towards the pit, and this Roche is not so going close. Quickly enough. Mon Ogier are going to be able to contest.
This Reaching Field just makes sure they actually can't blink in. Roche goes down, to Mill gets the Aegis though, and now Moon in trouble. Gem down on the deck, he's dead. For 67, he's got the buyback. I don't think you go any further if you're OG. Relocated, Sumail taking a lot of damage. He's got the Aegis, but now he's down. Miracle getting caught. Fear hits the Rage up before the Gust comes in, but here comes No-Tail. The split shot going through LD.
Buybacks, buybacks everywhere. Now Moon rejoins the fray. OG want to get something out of this, but Zai relocates back to safety. The last on Opec calling him. He will die. Universe trying to heal himself. They focus on Fear, dragging him back, slowing him down. The Eye of Scotty. Can they get the Life Stealer low? Gets off the cheese. Then the duel. EG somehow, someway, turning this fight around.
No-Tail won't die. He won't go down. Finally, it happens. Moon looking for more. Sumail is so low.
They're
gonna
not
be jump
done
in.
Yet, Mon. They're still going in.
It's four dead, and the only survivor is Fly. Fear looking to chase after him. No open wounds for three. Fly's very fast in his own right. They're going to get the Crystal Nova off, and Fear's diving towards the Tier 3 tower. Four step not there for five. That's no rage.
A triple dieback. If Fly goes down, they can't quite get him. Four heroes on the sideline.
He gets the gem, though.
Three of them for a minute. That top lane pushing in favor of the Dire. They might get a Rax here, but is it going to be enough? Because EG, a lot of time, Medusa just getting the gold now. Able to buy back. So they're only down a Drow and a Bat, but those are two important heroes. Can EG punish? Sumail committed for this. Buybacks everywhere. Still the creep swarming onto that melee Rex top, as we can see.
Yeah, the... they're going to lose melee Rex top. They might even lose range too. They have to back home. Fear doesn't have one.
Oh, EG. They really thought they could punish those diebacks, but it's the Drow precision aura. Oh, Mott. That hurts.
Yeah, that creep wave pushing in.
That is a massive creep wave.
Yep.
Some, you know, forget what I said about, you know, hitting good gusts is the mark of a great Drow player. Just press precision R and watch the creeps win you the game.
Yeah,
that's like when Drow first came out.
It's actually insane that the creeps were in that position. EG needed to deal with it before heading over to the Roche fight. But I mean, even if they did, it was just such a long fight that they weren't really noticing it or wasn't on their top list of priorities. They had a great fight. They killed four. They got a couple of buybacks. They killed more than four, in fact, because of those buybacks. Look at the buybacks on the... on your drop-down menu is actually nuts. If you click on it, there's like seven or eight of them that are just sitting with buyback, not available. Insane.
And Shadowblade now will be picked up by Universe, so... tries to get another form of initiation here. He bears the Lifestealer infested inside. And OG feeling... I would not say confident, but feeling like maybe they're back... they're able to apply pressure again. They lost all of their gold advantage off of that fight, but they gained an even greater Rax advantage. So it's going to come down to this engagement, but they have the high ground.
There's the scan. It's a little far away. The lasso. They break the Lincoln Spear. Sumail's caught. Relocate save. Not there in time. Sumail pulled away from Zai. Sumail about to go down. He doesn't have buyback, but Miracle getting caught. Here in trouble. No-Tail going to work, and there's the duel.
Wins it with the Queen of Pain dying back. Universe getting focused, the relocate save for now, but Marikold sees it as an opening. Blakes in, pulls off Universe, and with that, Zai forced to back away, so they find themselves EG 5v2 for a minute.
Those are the only two heroes that have a buyback, is of course Zai as well as Fear. They're healing up right now. They're about to lose another set of racks into Tier 3 tower. Not to mention top lane is still pushing in with a big creep wave yet again coming through. This is a tough hold. Sumail doesn't have buyback for another 4 minutes, so they won't be able to get the most important hero for EG back in, or at least one of the most important heroes, and there it is. Rax now gone, Fear blinks in, and he's about to get caught. Kited around, if it's going to work with Crit and the Hurricane Pike and the Moon Shard. Fear is dead, and that's it. It's GG.
GG. They turn around an 18,000 gold lead into nothing, and then they immediately lose the game. That is a heart-wrenching way to drop game one. They made this a lot closer than it looked like it should have been. There's some great execution, good pickoffs. I think the one thing that really hurt OG was there was like three or four fights in a row where the stone gaze was very late from No-Tail, and that allowed EG to find one, two kills off the bat and have a power play, but even so, just that one extra push over the hump was all it took.
Yeah, that was... I was surprised to see the fights